What is something you don't like reading? You hit
me up, it's late like a road at night. Trip. This long drive, is the same like in traffic, story. The worst. Your friend should take your phone away.
I always listen when you tell me lies to reassure me. You're on a road trip and you're hungry, and your iPad is just dying. And you're waiting at like the longest Chick-fil-A line ever. How do you act?
Very cranky.
Welcome to Chick-fil-A. How can I help you?
Need to demand for my food.
Hey, sir, actually, can you move up behind this car? Like, keep moving.
Right, okay.
So just because the car is behind you.
Okay, that's fine.
But what if it's not coming out very fast? How would you act then?
Yeah, can I get Chick-fil-A Deluxe? Yes, does it come with lettuce?
Oh, yes, sir, it does, actually.
It does? Okay,
yeah.
I don't actually want lettuce
I'll
up there.
Take it off.
That's
yes,
fine,
sir.
Okay.
I would throw a tantrum.
Also, can I get some barbecue?
Any other
No, I think I'm good, sir. Actually,
so what about drinks? What about
let me get a high C. Is that cool?
High C, okay, sir. That'll be actually $12.99.
$12.99.
$12.99. My blood for sir.
Okay, thank you, sir. Thank you. Deep down, I know that this should be the
last time I come over. You always leave me such a mess. And what was it you were waiting on? Would you rather wait in like a 2-hour Disney World line, or would you rather wait for 5 minutes staring at your phone for your phone to revive, for that little apple to appear?
2 hours for Disney World, because I've never gone before. First you say you love me, then you say you don't. I wake up in the morning and I'm all alone. Tell me that you're willing, then you say you won't. Can you make it mad? Oh, please, I'm losing my patience. Please, I'm losing my patience.
Only a tiny hole from which the bright thread hung. Carefully, he took hold of it and ran home. From that day forth, he began to pull the thread just a little bit every day. One day, however, it occurred to him it was stupid to pull the thread just a little. If he gave it a hard tug, school could be over altogether. Then he could start learning a trade and he could marry Liza. So that night, he gave the thread a mighty tug. And in the morning, he awoke to find himself apprentice to a carpenter. He loved his new life, clambering about on roofs and scaffolding and lifting and hammering great beams into place that smelled of the forest. But sometimes, when payday seemed too far off, he gave the thread a little tug, and suddenly, the week was drawing to a close, and he had money in his pocket. Liza had also come to town, and Peter began to grow impatient for the day when they would be married. In another year, I will have learned to be a capable wife.